Do not worry, I'm hearing your cries. I know you want to see every name to 500 first. I know you want to see every Phase 2 Clone Wars clone, but let me make what I want to make first. And I also need to kind of reserve some so I still have every Evers to make. So in the meantime, let's talk about this. I'm so happy to have this back in my collection. This is the Vintage Collection, ATAP. When I was younger, I always wanted an ATAP. Always. And I think it was 2012 when I finally got this thing. And, yeah, it's the Vintage Collection version, so it has, like, all the dark green on it, which is awesome, and I love it. But it's not specifically movie-accurate, but then again, you only saw this thing on Kashyyyk, so the dark green kind of fits. You might have seen this on Utapau. You might have. I don't know. I don't remember. It's been a while. And I see ATTs on Utapau. These are probably on Utapau, what am I talking about? But yeah, this is a great toy, man. It's not perfect, but it's pretty great. I remember when I was a kid, a classmate of mine brought in his ATAP into class as, like, you know, because you're allowed to, like, bring toys for whatever. And I just remembered being so jealous. Because I remembered he lifted this up and he saw that, like, you could put figures inside. And I think he had clones inside. And I was so jealous. So I was like, oh my gosh, clones. But now I have my own back. I traded this with my brother. I traded this for a Dark of the Moon Leader class Ironhide. But my brother just decided to give this back because he hasn't had it on display for, like, 7-8 years. So, thank you. I appreciate it. But yeah, there isn't too much to talk about with this vehicle. Here it is with a figure. We're just going to be comparing it with the Kashyyyk troopers. They're a little short for clones, but you can see the size there. It's a pretty sizable vehicle, man. It's not tiny. And you can see it's got, like, stripes right there. The legs can pose a little bit. You can get them down a little bit. You can make it taller if you want. But this is actually supposed to be, like, the proper length they are. Because you do have the middle leg, which is solely there just for support when it fires the big guns. So the... Because if it didn't have this middle leg to support it when it fired the big guns, like... Then this thing would probably just go... So yeah, kind of cool piece of design work. It's got the little gun down there, which I like. There's the bottom side, if you want to look at that. It's pretty neat. It's stuff, it's things. Kind of hollow limbs, but whatever, not the biggest deal. It's got some detailing back there, which is nice. It's got some thingies. It does have the turret on the top, which can rotate, and the button is right there. And you can fire that. That's cool. And then you have this big turret, which can come off. Doesn't really rotate. I think it's the main turret where, like, it goes... So, yeah, that's pretty cool. And then you have, of course, these flaps, which I love the detail. I love that it has a little bit of a window right there. I wish that that canopy would open up or something, but it's all right. I think this vehicle is a little undersized, to be honest, because I don't feel like... They just sit in there like that. I feel like there's probably more of an interior to this vehicle. You can see there's some control panels. There's a seat. It's kind of got a bit of an armrest. Let's get a clone in there and see how he looks. So getting this guy in there. You can see they kind of lean back a bit. He's got that backpack piece, so he's not going to be perfectly flush. You can get the hand on that little yoke right there. Yeah, he can fit. It can close. It's a pretty nice fit, man. That looks nice. And then, of course, you got two seats. So let's give him a bud. Let's get another clone in there. So yeah, you can get clones in there. They look cool. God, I love this vehicle. I can't wait to redo my Kashyyyk display to have these guys, to have this vehicle in the display. That looks so nice. And you can close it up. Can't really see him in there once it's closed up, but that's all right. Yeah, it looks so cool seeing two troopers in there like that. Gosh, I love this. I wish I had it when I was growing up, when I was a kid. But unfortunately, I did not. And then, la piece de resistance, the turret. Who else but one of the rarest figures ever? Let's get this rare boy up there. Because I need to, hey. You know how much of a pain it was for me to get this figure? I'm going to show it off from time to time, okay? I'm going to show it off. Sometimes I'm going to be a bit of a show-off. Oh my gosh, I'm straining this rare figure. Please, please just get in there. I'm straining him. Oh no. There we go. I'm not going to worry about getting his hands on the handles. They can go on it. Don't worry about it. But yeah, there we go. There isn't too much else to talk about. There's the ATAP. It's kind of funny how these vehicle reviews, like, there's not as much to talk about with a big vehicle like this, and sometimes just a standard little figure. But I love this vehicle. Like I said, I have some childhood memories of wanting it, but no childhood memories of having it. So it's definitely an absolute pleasure to have this thing now. You gotta have the turret straight to actually have the flaps open. But yeah, I can sit three figures, which is awesome. And it's just an impressive vehicle. They have released it a multitude of ways, but this is the Vintage Collection Green release. So it fits with 41st Elite. And that's awesome. It's not particularly film accurate, but hey, I think it's cool that they did this from time to time. And hey, it's green, it fits, I like it. I don't really need another ATAP in my life, this is good. So there we go, guys. Unfortunately, this clone corner will be cut short, but there just isn't much else to talk about. There we go, ATAP, man. I love it. I highly recommend it. Get yourself an ATAP if you don't have one, especially if you're into the 41st Elite stuff, especially if you want your clones to have an AT-ST equivalent in your collection, because AT-RTs are cool, but they're just so tiny, they're not as substantial as an ATAP. You know, these things are pretty... I mean, you saw how the figure was just down there. This is a pretty substantial vehicle. It's going to take up a lot of space on the shelf whenever I decide to make the space for it. So yeah, there we go. Make sure to comment, like, and subscribe. Check out my social media links, PO Box address, and frequently asked questions down in the description below. Have a good day, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.